السلام عليكم شيخ.
وعليكم السلام.
Well, since you mentioned religion, what is the importance nowadays of religion in a work?
Well, what would we be, what would we know without traditions? Yeah. And the traditions were brought through the religious world, no? Until still up today, they are brought to us. Yeah. All our knowledge and all our inner perspectives have been, of course, very much taken fruit through the religious world. Yeah. There is no doubt about that. Yeah. There was a famous master, let's say, in the last century. No, his name was Osho. Yeah, you surely have heard about him. No? And he talked a lot of speeches, but almost everything he talked was related to one religious tradition. Yeah. If it wasn't there, if it would not have been exist, there would not have been much material to talk about. Yeah. So, for me, the religions are still valid. Yeah. And the only thing is, in my view, yeah, religions are in crisis. Yeah. So many people say, religions are not anymore necessary, we don't need them anymore. And it is a dangerous currency somehow, you know, because it is this over-ego which thinks it knows everything by itself. Yeah. And we do not need help from our ancestors, from our people who were living before us. Yeah. On the other hand, the religious world presents themselves very poor. No? And everywhere there is dissatisfaction. Either we have artifacts like in the Islamic world, these very violent groups which have nothing to do with the religion itself, but they are considering themselves part of it. Yeah. And in the public, the common perception is these people, they belong to Islam. Yeah. There's these artifacts, you have them everywhere. Yeah. Now the Buddhists, they kill the Rohingya people, yeah, in Burma. Yeah. That is not valid in the Buddhist concept. It is nowhere in any concept valid that people kill people. This is not valid in anyone. Yeah. And I think we have to go very much, we have to emphasize, yeah, that non-violence is a part of our next human step. Yeah. It cannot be that we have every single day murder, torture, threats, abuse in our world. Yeah. That cannot be the final answer. And we have to react on that. Yeah. So, I think we fulfill our religious duties when that all is stopped. Then we can say we succeeded. No. And nothing can be defended. Yeah. You cannot defend the killing of somebody. Yeah. No. Yeah. Every life is sacred. It says in the Book of Love, the Holy Quran, you take the life of one, it is equivalent as if you took the life of all humanity. Live what you preach. No? That is very, very, very important. Yeah. And the religious people should be the first, yeah, to show tolerance, to show easiness, and to show us a straightness, yeah, to be in contact, yeah, with environment and so on and so on. And so they should have a leading role in the conscious work. No? If the youngsters feel not attracted by them, that means something goes wrong there. Yeah. And most people are angry with the religious world. No, yeah. They feel it is not true in a way anymore. It's not relevant also for their daily life, no? So we have to try to give good examples, no? Not to shut people down, no? Not to put them also in this conflict. Follow a religion or not, what kind of conflict should that be? Yeah. That is an artificial conflict. That is an unnecessary conflict. Yeah. It should not be there. Yeah. But as I said before, for me personally, the most important now is to look to the foundation, which is our nature, which is our world, our earth. Everything should go there. So we have a big wave now at the moment that children, they stand up and they scream for help. Yeah. They scream also out of fear because they are saying we feel in danger. Yeah. We feel not taken care for. Yeah. So that should be our common interest first. No? When that is arrived, we can be calmer. No? And we should take examples from people who live in harmony with the earth, yeah? Since ever. Yeah? We should look at them and hear, what do they say? What is their advice to us? Yeah? Because obviously this is the only species, the only part of humans, who had not participated in the destruction of it. Or maybe it's not a bad idea to hear what they say. Yeah? The so-called primitives, yeah? The indigens. No? Maybe we should start to listen. How did they see it? Yeah? How did they manage to live all thousands of years in peace? Yeah? We are saying we have civilization. Yeah, thank you. It is a civilization which is suicidal. Yeah? Which kills each other in periods of time. And it happened before us. So maybe it is time to come a little down, no, in our pride and say, look at those people. Yeah. It is a very much a personal matter for me, yeah, to protect nature as much as I can and to contribute on that and to protect the people who showed an example how to live in harmony with nature. Yeah. This is what I'm telling my children and my grandchildren and everyone who sits with me and is ready to listen. Yeah. Let your first thought go in the morning towards nature. Yeah. That is our door to the divine. Yeah. Like Hafiz said, if you want to reach God, yeah, become human. So let us be humans. No? There is no need, there is no time now for pride, for putting your crown on your head and saying, I am this, I am that, I know more than you. Yeah? No. Yeah. We have to become real brothers, real sisters. Yeah. In the love of, for the love of this earth, for the love of the creator of this earth. No. This is what we should try. No. Mm. Mm.